Starting with the number of vertices 9, the basic geometry that we have is a monocapped square antiprism. The base polyhedra is a square antiprism. This is one square. Another square staggered to it. And well, here is a ninth vertice that will cap one of the square faces. So let me draw one of the squares. This is one square, and let me draw the second one. The second square must be staggered to the first one. Later on, the general strategy from top to bottom and then bottom to top. As we join the two squares, that would generate 8 triangular faces between the two squares. As I draw, you can count the number of triangles that are generated. Well, when this last edge is drawn, it will generate 2 triangular faces. Now this is joined to the square face that generates 4 triangular faces. Right. We have 8 triangular faces from the parent polyhedra, 4 newly generated triangular faces. This is a square face that can be counted. This is a square face that gets embedded, and hence it should not be counted. Well, coming to the number of faces, it's 12 triangular faces, and one square face. The symmetry belong to C4V. Here is the C4 rotational axis. That belong to C4V point group. The next one being the tri-capped trigonal prism. There are 3 caps. Let me choose 2 triangles, and these 2 triangles are eclipsed to one another. I've chosen in such a way that the 2 triangles are moving away from one another towards the viewer. Let me join the vertices to make it into triangles. That's one triangle. A second triangle is now being constructed. So these are the 2 triangular faces. Now let's join the top vertice to the bottom vertice. Since they are not staggered, that would not generate more number of triangular faces. It is not a trigonal antiprism, it is simply a trigonal prism. This is one square face where one vertice will cap, a second square face, another vertice, third square face, and a third vertice will cap to it. These are those 3 vertices, and let's cap it to these corresponding square faces. As the new vertice cap one of the square faces, it generates 4 triangular faces altogether. So 4 triangular faces have already been generated from one newly added vertice. The second vertice is adding 4 more triangular faces, making it 8. This is a vertice that is away. And well, this will also generate 4 triangular faces. It is generating 4 triangular faces. Altogether making 12 triangular faces that are newly generated. 4, 4. And these are 4, 12, along with the already existing 1 and 2. 12 plus 2 makes it 14. The square face, second square face, and a third square face are getting embedded and hence they should not be counted. Twelve newly generated and two from the parent, making it 14 triangular faces, and every square face is symmetrically capped and hence this also belongs to D3H as that of its parent trigonal prism.